Okay, so welcome to all. So today we are going to learn, suppose microcontroller is sending some data through serial port, multiple data. Say microcontroller is connected with multiple sensors, so that sensor's value it is that microcontroller is sending through serial port. That data you have to receive and you have to see it in your Android device through through that Bluetooth communication. It is, even though it will work as a serial communication. Okay, so the code is very simple code. See, this is the code. It's very simple. So one variable is storing, this is the millis, and then it is divided by whatever the milli, you know, millis, what is millis? It is the time of from when the controller is on, it will display the it will count the millisecond. It's like a timer or clock. Then simply I have used, it is divided by 3000. Then another is, we are from the analog channel A0, we are reading the value, and those are printed here, and there will be a delay of every 1 second we will be reading it. So this is a simple code. Okay, so this is the simple code. So now I am coming to the app which will be used to read that. So you see, this is a list picker. So this already we know it. During the sending of data, we have understood what is that. This will connect Bluetooth. Okay, and you have to take a clock. So that clock time interval also 1 second. If every 1 second, we will be using that clock in every 1 second. 1000 means 1000 millisecond. So here I have used one level which is called first value, and this is the second value. Just I have given the variable name like that. Okay, other things are very simple. So now I am coming to the blocks. So this is the block. So this part already we know, we need not to discuss it, because for during the data sending we have used the same thing. This is basically nothing but during the connection of Bluetooth device. Okay, and here I have initialized the, you see, first I'll come to this. So I am initialize the received data as null, nothing. And also, because as I told, the data will be sent as comma separated value. Say it will be always transmitted like 1, 2 or 3, 1000, like that some value. All the values will be separated by comma. So first I have initialized the entire data, whatever it is received as line. So that variable name I have given as received data, that is also initialized as null, nothing. Then I am splitting that received data by comma. Where the comma is there, first comma is there, that I am storing in a data set, in a variable called data set. It's an array. So that is data set 1, data set 2, like that we are. That also initialized as empty. Okay, And when that clock or timer is available, then what I am giving an if then condition. You see the color, whatever color I have used here, from there you can see all the blocks will be there. So if and then, so if the Bluetooth client is connected, so this will be available in the Bluetooth section. So if you go Bluetooth here, you will get that. Then under that also I am giving one more condition. Then Bluetooth, if the bytes received is greater than zero, then you just whatever data is received by the Bluetooth, that you store in the variable called received data. Then I am, because as I told, all the data which will be received and stored in received underscore data, that is separated by comma. You see, that's why here split, I have used split text at. So whatever data you have received in the variable called received underscore data, there all the value which is separated by comma, that I am inserting in an array called data set. Okay. Then in the label, that which is I have written as f val means first value, that from the data set the first element, that means data set 1, that I am displaying. And here for second value also we are taking the data set with index 2, then I am clearing the received underscore data and that list, that array also I am clearing. So this is the simple code. It is very simple to understand. People who know very basic C or this kind of programming language, they will understand very easily. It is very simple. So using that thing, you can, whatever data it is sent by the controller, that you can catch, you can capture, and you can display it. So basically this course, whatever I have, this is the, with this we will be concluding that course. So this is basically, I have in this is a very basic course for IoT application. Microcontroller, to control anything, you need to send data to microcontroller or receive data from microcontroller. So that things we have seen through Python as well as through Android app also. So if we understand these techniques, then we can control our home appliance or industrial gears, anything we can control it. So this was all about the discussion of today. So now I will request Vishwa to run that app and explain it. Vishwa, can you share your screen and that? Yeah. You see, after now he will be connected. See, selecting the device which is HC05. Now you see, it is connected. You see, now simply because we don't have potentiometer. So first what we will do, the first value is will be changing. Why this kind of minus coming now? It is overflow error, because that is a selection of data type that you can do later also, because it is overflow of the data, that's why it's coming minus. So now all this problem is coming due to that only. Now the second value, basically the analog channel value. So now can you connect that analog channel, A0 channel, to ground? You see, once it is connected to ground, so the second value is coming as zero, nothing is connected. Now can you connect to that channel to 3.3 volt? You see, 3.3 volt means accordingly it's a 10 bit ADC, I think. So it will be around coming 670, something like that. Now can you connect these things to 5 volt? You see, 5 volt means 2 to the power 10, 2 to the power 10 minus 1, so it is 1023, it's coming. So this is the very basic technique I have shown you in the entire course. So using that you can develop your own app or own program, software for your customized applications also. So hope this things it will be useful for you all. Thank you so much.